For truing the wheel, we have to assemble first the bearings. We have new bearings made by Koyo. The type of the bearing is 6303. We have also the spacer here with the shims, and we have to put them here inside. So first we put the shim inside here. We are lubricating a little here. These are modern bearings. They have seals. We don't have to lubricate anymore. They have the grease inside from the factory. And here we will assemble the greaser, but only for design purposes. We will not use anymore the greaser in order to grease the bearings. Now the second bearing, but before that we have to put the spacer. We have already inside the shim, and the role of the shim is this one. It has to keep the spacer centered inside the hub. So we put the spacer inside, we put the second shim. Always kick in the outer racing of the bearing, not the inner one, because if we kick in the inner race, we are kicking in the balls of the bearing. And now we have the second bearing assembled, and we are ready to train the wheel. So now we have the wheel in the train stand, and we have to make the wheel. So first we have to check if we have some two loose spots. So it was this one. So we have checked all, and now we can start screwing. And first we have to inspect the spokes in order to see if we have nipples which are screwed too much. And I have this one. I will lose it a little. Also this one. You have this area that from my point here is in the left, and I have to center more to the right. And it seems to be that is the only area that I have to center. And also I have to check up and down. Up and down it is okay, but after I will screw the spokes, I have to verify with the wire very near. Asta nu cred că pot să pun multe pe fil. Am uitat. After some hours I have finished to through the wheels, and they are both ready to be assembled with the spoke bands, with the tubes and the tires. I have the tires right over there. We have the bearings installed. On the rear wheel we don't have bearing inside the breakdown, because the bearings for the rear wheel are in the rear transmission, and also this bearing which is mounted on the frame. This is one of the bearings for the rear wheel. This is a new one. It looks just fine. I have tested also on the frame. And now we have to assemble the tires. This is the band spokes. It is 30 millimeter wide. I think originally is 28 millimeter, but as you may see, 30 millimeter is just good. Before installing the tire, we have to put French torque inside. This French torque will allow for the tube to sit better in the tire when you inflate the tube. All the torque in the walls. Thank you. first part have passed. I have managed to assemble the tire without levers. I have put also here French torque because this way it is easier to inflate the tire for the first time in order to arrange the tire on the rim.